Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to read dump files on Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. So I'm currently on a Windows 11 system, and dump files are basically the files that are created when your system has a BSOD error or the blue screen error. And these files are really helpful to troubleshoot these blue screen errors because they contains the significant information about the cause which triggered that BSOD or blue screen error. But reading them is a quite challenging thing because the DMP files are basically in a format that is not easy to understand. And for that, you can use this step-by-step guide to read the dump files. So first of all, we have to download the WinDbg preview from the Microsoft Store, and this tool helps us to understand and read the dump files. So the link for this app has been mentioned in the video description. You can also open the Microsoft Store app on your system and search for WinDbg preview. I'll just click on the Get in Store app here, and this will launch the Microsoft Store, and here you can install this app from the app page. I already have installed WinDbg preview, so I just have the open button here. But when you will be looking forward to this page on the Microsoft Store, you will have the install button. You can just use the install button to get this app. Alright, so the app has been installed on my system. I will just launch it using the search, and here you need to make sure that you select run as administrator. Otherwise, you may not be able to open dump files. So the WinDbg has been started in administrative mode. Just click on file there and select open dump file. Now browse through the location for the dump file you want to open. Generally, they are located in the system root folder of the installation, and then mini dump folder. And when you paste that location, it goes to the C drive. If your installation is on C drive, then go to Windows folder and then dump file. Now just pick up the DMP file which caused the BSOD error. You can use the timestamp or the date modified to determine which dump file you have to open. Just click on the open button here, and the dump file is now loaded. We have to just click on the analyze space dash v command, and once we just click on that, the tool will automatically perform the BSOD bug check analysis. And here you can see that the bug check analysis has been performed and the BSOD error has been mentioned here, along with the cause which triggered the error. And this was some error I received on the system due to the memory issue. I can just go through the details for this bug check analysis. And then here I found the driver which caused this error. It has been mentioned here. The bthport.sys, this is the driver name which caused the BSOD error. I can just use the Google search to find out what this specific driver is for, and then carry out the further troubleshooting and remove that driver or update that driver to fix that BSOD error. Now let's perform the bug check analysis for another DMP file, because I also get the different BSOD error, and I just used the analyze command. And here under bug check analysis, I found that this was video scheduler internal error, and I can just copy that BSOD error name and just search it in order to find the more information about that. So this is official page from Microsoft which mentions this error. Here it says the parameter which can cause the error. I have to find it out. And the parameter first is the driver has reported an invalid fence ID, and the same error I have got on my system. Okay, so here the resolution is also mentioned. And the resolution is, if the faulty module listed in the analyze output is a video driver, see if updates are available for that video driver from the vendor. And in order to resolve this error, I just updated the graphics drivers and the error was resolved itself. So this is how you can use dump file to analyze the BSOD errors and troubleshoot them accordingly. That's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.